Nelson Coughlin with the Varsity Sports Network, talking to Northeast Coast Roger O'Day after a big win at North County. Coach, both teams struggled mightily for three quarters.
Yeah,
their zone was giving me a tough time.
Yeah, both of us came out of the zone for the same reason. We know offensively, man-to-man, we had the top two guards, backcourt in the county. It's been tough for people to keep us. We've been getting big leads, and then people have to come out of that zone, and then we eat them up with our dribble drive.
Who are those two guards?
That's Trent McNeil, is a junior, and Jalen Alberry. And he's a senior this year.
Jalen, okay.
Yeah, so that's why we went
so
with
the zone. So you see a lot of zone.
Yeah, well, we've been seeing both. We've been seeing a lot of man early, but now everybody's going to zone or going to a 3-2 on us. And we got a lot of quick hitters there. But tonight we struggled. Actually, our last two games we have struggled. Arundel got us pretty good with their 3-2 zone. But we came in knew they were going to do it. We had some little wrinkles. We just couldn't get anything going early. We lost some of our intensity. Our guards got a little bit of foul trouble earlier. So we couldn't generate as many turnovers off our defense to get out in transition like we would like to. So that cost us a little bit on the offensive side.
Yeah, but, couldn't get too many easy buckets here.
No, but our defense held tight. You know, 15 and a half. It was a horrible first half for both teams. But our zone did our job. We knew that they were going to struggle shooting from the outside. We really wanted to concentrate on their all-county player, Omichi, number 10 for them. He's a very fantastic player. He's going to go someplace if he keeps his head on his shoulders. So we really kind of slid to his side as much as he can, made sure he didn't catch the ball in the middle.
He's
the key to them. That was another reason. We usually press a lot. But tonight we held back on our press. Like I said, we got in foul trouble, but we also didn't want to open anything up and let him get going and get flowing and get him a dunk early so all of a sudden he's in the game. We want to try to keep him out of the game as much as we could.
Yeah, talk about Mr. Dependable inside, Steve. What do you mean? He's like a rock in there. You can't move him. Right?
Steve's strong. Steve's big. Steve's been on varsity since a freshman. His playing time just keeps getting bigger. He's been swapping back and forth at the starting spot this year. Sometimes Trent and Cauley starts, but Steve earned a start tonight. And then, you know, Trent didn't get much time tonight because Steve was just eating. Steve, what's good about Steve is he knows our team. He knows Jalen Alberry. He knows McNeil. He knows we're trying to get in the paint, and he always has his hands ready. And a little good secret about Steve is he's left-handed, so he sits on that left block, and he just puts it right up, and he has his hands ready. So he's a tight end on the football team. He actually has some colleges looking at him for football. So he's actually one of Northeast. We haven't had it happen in a long time. It's very rare, but he's going to get 12 varsity letters. He's varsity football as a freshman, varsity basketball as a freshman, and varsity lacrosse as a freshman. So he's a very talented athlete. He's got to get quicker in his footwork. But he was pretty physical. He's our big body. So.
He seems to know his role.
Yes, he does. And that's the key. We got a brotherhood here. I actually grabbed a lot of these kids when they were in fifth grade, gave them some fake scholarships, joking around, keep my players at home. A lot of them are brothers of some of my past teams that were really well. Like Travis Smoot is Trent Smoot's brother who could have played D1. He's actually playing D2 at Erskine right now. So Travis stepped up in the Meade game, dropped 18 points down for us. We got Daryl. Daryl has been doing amazing this year. He's been a double-double guy for us at the four spot. That's Daryl Shepard, and he's having an all-county year. You know, tonight he was a little sluggish, but he gets a lot of rebounds for us, and his mid-range is really good. He's averaging about 12 points and about 8 rebounds a game.
Well, so, fourth quarter, you open it up 18-3 run. Talk about that.
You know, I like to say there wasn't no coaching there. There's a lot of coaching leading up to this, but in-game coaching, I mean, that's Jalen Alberry just taking over. You know, I'm on him constantly telling him he's got to be the man to put us on his back. And tonight he just took over. I mean, in my opinion, he's the top player in the county right now. I tried to say that last year. Now all the coaches are coming to me telling me, yeah, we missed that. You're right. He's definitely a top five player in the county, but I think he's number one in the county. You win with guards and, you know, I mean, like I said, I didn't have to do as much coaching right there. That's him in his own will, his own energy, getting into that paint and doing what needed to be done. And he's going to break the career assist record at our school that's been held since 1992 by Gene Playo, which is 338 assists. Wow. Jalen's going to shatter that. I better start checking because he's probably 20 assists shy right now. He's had a couple 11 assists, 12 assist games, so he's not a eye player.
Sure, when he has over 300 assists.
For his career. Yeah, okay. And I can give you that final exact number. I just got to look through my huddle. Okay. But I mean, he's pass first, and he knows his body, controls his body, he knows if he's going to finish, or he's always looking for someone else. He gets the team involved.
He's a solid kid too.
Yes, he is. Yes, he is. And his ball handling is phenomenal. I coached him in the eighth grade game, Northeast versus Chesapeake substance abuse game, which is a fun game with the middle school kids. And we beat Chesapeake that game. It was 10 seconds left in the game, and he's trapped. And I'm about to call timeout. And this young man is an eighth grader. And granted, I only got to talk to him after school and coach him a little bit. He pulled some move where he went through his legs and split the trap. And then finished it with a pass to Brian Titus, who finished it up with a layup. And we win the game. It was a middle school game. And so that's where it all started. I knew I had the guy right at that play because my jaw dropped and I didn't have to call timeout.
He's a senior now?
He's a senior.
Do we know where he's going?
He has a lot of schools looking at him. But believe it or not, of all schools, he really likes Hood. He loves the coaching staff, and he feels it's a good fit for him. He likes their offense. He likes the guys. He's been up there a couple times to meet the guys, visit the campus. We've been to their shootout the last 3 years. So we go up there, introduce them, and that coach, he's called me every week to talk to, about Jay. And so they kept in contact, and Jay went up there for a showcase camp and all. So they really put a lot of love into him, and they might get him just because that. Even though he could go higher up, it's about what fits best for him and the relationships, and that's what's going on with him right now. Jay's probably about 15 points a game and probably about 8 to 9 assists a game. I can give you the exact numbers a little bit later.
15 and 8.5.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. Well, listen, that's a big win for you guys. Still unbeaten, right?
We are now 8-1.
You're 8-1.
As our regular season record, we're 7-0.
Okay.
Yeah, 7-0.
What are you in the county?
In the county, we haven't lost. So we beat Meade by 30. We beat Glen Burnie by 25. We beat Chesapeake by 50. We just beat North County.
4-0.
We beat Wild Lake, but they're not. That was Anne Arundel Tower.
So
that's over
4-0.
There. We beat Southern Maryland. Yeah, so we might be 4-0 in the county.
Good start.
Yes, sir.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Thanks for your time. Appreciate it.